Hello friends, now coming towards our next topic, that is departmental undertakings. Okay, first of all, let's take a revision of our previous session where we have discussed that our business enterprises are basically divided in three sectors, where first one is your public, second one is your private, and third one was your global enterprises, right? Over there, we have already discussed that we have studied regarding private enterprise in our last chapter, which was your forms of business organization, right? Which were your sole proprietor, partnership, etc., right? Now it's time to learn regarding public sector enterprises, and we have already discussed that this public sector is further divided in three forms of organization, where first one is your departmental undertaking, second one is your statutory corporation, and third one is your government company, right? So now it is time to learn regarding the first form of organization of the public sector. So that is why we are starting with the departmental undertakings. So let's start with the first form of organization under your public sector, which is your departmental undertakings. As the name says, it is departmental, right? It means it is something linked with the government departments. So while defining the departmental undertaking, we can say these are the enterprises which are established as departments of ministry. So can I have few of the examples? You guys might be aware regarding few of any of the departments which you know, which you might know regarding the as a government department. So any examples? Yes, the most common example, if we will talk about it, is your railway departments, right? Similarly, telephone departments, so that is what we call telecommunication. Post offices, so post and telegraph. And any other? Defense department, this is the most common department, right? As a government, you guys should know, be known regarding that the defense forces, such as where your aircrafts, where your other elements of your which one used at the time of war. Okay, so these are basically those departments of ministry which are established for the functioning of government. Okay, so apart from this definition, we can say, as if we have studied here about these department, it is your most oldest and most traditional form of public sector enterprise. Most traditional form of public sector enterprise. Okay. And one more thing we can say, as if these departments are departments of ministry. So, as the function of government, if we will talk about in this, perhaps we can say that the government functions through these departments, and the activities performed by them are the integral part. These are basically the integral part, because one basically known these departments only as a government sector, right? So these are the integral part of business organizations for the government. So apart from this, as we have discussed now the definition of departmental undertakings, now let us discuss regarding the features, and after that the merits and demerits of such business enterprises. Okay, so as we said that these are the integral part of government sector, right? So what can be the features of it? First of all, if we will talk about to start up a business, what we need is funding, right? So from where the funding of such enterprise of public sector will come? It will directly come from the direct leak comes from the government treasury. Government treasury. That is from where the government uses the fund that, or you can say, to which the revenue is revenue come to the government is the only source by which it passes for the expenditures as well for departmental undertakings. Say, as if you all of you knows that railway being a department of revenue, right? It basically generates the revenue for the government. Now, as if being a part of departmental undertaking is providing revenue to the government. So, it's obvious in case any of the funds are required for repairing or any of other expenditures to be incurred by railway department, then from where the railway department will ask for the fund? Obviously, from the government treasury to which it has provided the revenue, right? So, we can say that the funding is directly linked with the government treasury. Okay, now coming towards the next feature, it's regarding the control. Okay, so control in the form of whether it is your accounting or your auditing. Just like the other government enterprises are to be managed, are to be controlled, similarly with the same rules and regulation, your departmental undertakings are also controlled and managed by the government. Okay, now coming towards the next feature, it is regarding the employees of such undertakings. So who are the employees of such undertakings? As we said that the funds are provided by the government. So it's obvious these employees are also remunerated by the government only. So that is why these employees will gonna work for government. So these are known as government servants. Okay. So the employees of departmental undertakings are the government servant, as their recruitment as well as other conditions, say, or even the remuneration payment are done by the government only. Now coming towards the next next characteristic, it is your accountability. We have discussed regarding the control. Now it's time to discuss the accountability. As if these are the departments of ministry, right, and controlled and managed just like the other government enterprises by the ministry only. Thus, it's obvious that they are accountable only to the ministry, right? So we can say that these departments are accountable to the ministry as they are managed by the ministry. Now coming towards the next characteristic, as we have already discussed that these departments are establishment of government of ministry, established as the department of ministry. So we can say that these are the subdivision of government departments and subject to the direct control of ministry. Okay, so friends, these are the features where we have discussed regarding the departmental undertaking, which is basically the establishment of which are basically established as departments by the ministry, right? So as if these are the public undertakings and established as a department of ministry, the revenue of which are to be submitted under the government treasury, and any expenditure if these departments require, they will directly take help of the government treasury. So the funding is directly come from the government treasury. Now if we'll talk about control, these are controlled by the, as if the other government agencies are controlled, other government enterprises are controlled by the ministry, they are controlled by the ministry only. The employees of these enterprises are the government servants and they are accountable to the ministry. And we have already discussed that these are the subdivisions of government departments. Okay, friends, so this is all about your department undertakings concept. In our next class, we're going to learn regarding the merits and demerits of departmental undertakings. For the further classes, please download our app, Scholars Learning. And in case you have already downloaded our app, hope now you will clear with the concept. Hope you will get few other examples in your bookish language. Thank you.